Hey guys, welcome back. Haven't posted in a while. Been pretty busy this summer. It's been a hot summer too up in New Jersey. But in this video, I'm going to be showing how to remove the engine mounts on the 2003 Honda Accord with the K24 engine. I'm going to also show removing it out, and then just a couple of things what you can see when you have the motor out. For this particular project, we're replacing the engine. I take the whole trans and motor out just to show how I do it, and I like doing it that way. It's just a little bit easier, in my opinion. But I'm sure there's many ways to do it. Some people swap the transmissions while the motor's still in the car, or vice versa. You know, however you want to do it, it's, you know, definitely possible. But I'm just showing how I did it, and after I get it out, I'll show that I'm just putting it down. I'll get ready to take off the starter and like this core converter, the motor mounts, or the back mount that mounts to the engine itself. So now I'm starting with the shift linkage under the car. Those are 10 millimeter bolts, breaking them all loose, getting them out. And here's another angle so you can see it from the other side. That housing is what I'm trying to unbolt to take off and disconnect the linkage so we can pull the motor and trans out. Looks like it's like almost 4 or 5 bolts. And there you go, the thing pops out and you can see the linkage cable going through. I'm just putting some anti-seize to give it like a mark of where it should be back into park or neutral, however I keep it. So right there, I'm trying to show you there's a 10 millimeter bolt that holds that shift cable onto the transmission's shift anvil, or whatever you want to call it. And there's a locking tab wrapping or holding the bolt. So you can't really loosen the bolt without taking that tab off, or at least backing it off. There you go, I got the tab. Now I'm using a 10 millimeter disconnect, or take that bolt out to disconnect the shift linkage. There you go, and it just slides right off. And now I'm showing the exhaust bolts, right? So this has the exhaust manifold towards the firewall of the engine, or towards the back of the engine, or towards the firewall. Anyway, so these are the bolts that connect the muffler to the header. And I'm just disconnecting these two just to be able to get the motor out. The rest of the exhaust can stay in. And right here, I'm showing you the other bolt came out easily. This bolt literally just snapped. Very common. Exhaust bolts tend to rust a lot faster because of the heat. So just got to replace those bolts. That's all. Now I'm under the car, wrapping the chain that I'm going to use to lift the engine out with my engine hoist. I'm wrapping the chain under the transmission. And then I'll go over to the driver's side engine mount post. Or engine post mount. Yep. So I got my buddy Nardo help me pull the chain up to wrap it around and secure it. So if you haven't seen the other videos, I already got the axles out, the radiators out. All that was left was that shift linkage and exhaust from under the vehicle, and the rest of the stuff we take off or disconnect is going to be above. Or the engine bay, and literally it's just the 4 engine mounts. What we're gonna do is, though, we're gonna wrap the chain around, secure it, make sure it's pretty tight, and yeah, see right here, I'm trying to show that I'm wrapping the chain under the engine's post mount on the passenger side. And right here, I was out of angle, but I showed that's how I'm wrapping the chain, just going right around the mount. That 114 millimeter bolt is all I'm gonna take out, and then I'll just pull the whole motor up with the post on. The post still mounted to the engine block. That's just the excess chain. I'm just putting it on top to get it out the way. But what I'm doing is wrapping the chain, and right there I'm putting a bolt to lock the chain to just make a closed loop so it doesn't slip off or unravel and the engine falls off. But so I'm locking the chain to keep it tight, and then I'm gonna put some tension onto the chain or start to lift the engine hoist. There you go, that's the engine hoist I got, Old Harbor Freight Special. So we're gonna put some tension on that chain. I'll try to get the weight of the engine onto the engine hoist so I can start unbolting the engine mounts. Because if you try to unbolt the engine mounts with the weight on, it kind of strips the bolts or it can damage the threads. So right here you see I'm just trying to get tension on the engine. So right here I'm just trying to get some weight on the engine hoist, and then I'm starting to unbolt the motor mounts. So up front, this is two 14 millimeters holding this bracket, and then there's a third bolt that you unbolt to get to the motor mount itself, so the engine could be lifted.
Perfect.
I'm showing the passenger side mount. I unscrewed that one. Now this is the back trans bracket mount. This is what holds the engine and transmission assembly to the engine's subframe. Again, it's another 14 millimeter bolt. And it has a bracket. Yep, that bracket right there goes over the mount, and it has two 14s holding it down. Once you get that out, you just got to get this third 14 millimeter bolt that goes into the mount itself. And then the engine will be able to go up or lift up. Right here is a little hard to see because this is the firewall and it's just like no space. And you got the engine hoses and engine harness all in the way. Some safety glasses we dropped in there.
I had to break it.
Alright, right here I'm just making sure right here we got the chain tight, and I'm starting to see that it's kind of like hitting on the valve cover and that breather tube. So I'm just trying to move the hose, move the chain over, just make sure we're not damaging any engine components. There's all kinds of ways to lift a motor out. You could use, you know, nylon tow straps. There's engine balancers that have like a bar with a worm gear to try to change the angle, and it has different chain points. You could just put it on like a bolt somewhere on the engine, but this is just a quick general way I usually do it. Just wrap a giant chain around the whole assembly, lock it in with a bolt, and then just pull it out. It's a heavy duty towing chain, so it never fails. I think it's about 10 feet long. There you go, see I got the bolt locked in. Keep the chain from unraveling, just to keep it snug. And right here, I'm just showing you we're getting the harness out of the way, the fuse box out of the way, to get to the passenger side engine mount. And here you see I got all my tools just laid out on the floor. We're doing this in my buddy's driveway. I brought all the tools. He had the customer and that brought the car and the engine, and we made it happen in his driveway. Right here I'm just matching up the bolts or the sockets or whatever I need. I think it was like a 16 millimeter or 17 on these transmission mount bolts. And then there's some 14s holding the transmissions mount to the car's frame, or that frame rail right there. Yeah, see, I got the 14 on there. Got my long ratchet. These bolts are pretty tight. First time this motor's probably ever been taken out of this 2003 Accord. Right here, I'm just putting the intake manifold back on. We'll have to get it off again to get that starter that's under there out. But we'll do that when we get the motor out to swap it with the other. That starter's good, so we're gonna put it on the other motor. Since the other motor starter probably sat for a while, we don't want to take a chance of it, you know, seizing up or stop working. Still working on those passenger side trans mount bolts, getting them all out. Remember, we've got the engine's weight supported by the engine hoist now with the chain, so we're unbolting all these engine mount bolts, which is, this is the last side that we're doing actually, and then we'll be able to start jacking it up. Oh, and then the one in the front, of course. Like I said, we took you saw me earlier unbolting that bracket. Now I'm doing the little center bolt. And then we're just going to take all the bolts out and start to lift the engine up. There you go. All right, so here we're starting to lift up on the engine, making sure we got all our engine harness connections disconnected. Making sure everything's looking good. We already drained the coolant. So, like I said, we got the radiator out too. Just another close-up of trying to get the last bolt off that transmission mount on the passenger side. It was a little hard to reach. It's just a tight setup there. There you get the mount out. And there we go. We're starting to lift the engine up. Just using a pry bar to try to push it away from that mount side, or just trying to free it up. Remember, the AC compressor was already disconnected. We didn't evacuate the system, so we left it hooked up. So we just had to unbolt it and then let it hang. And then that's pretty much it. You see the thing's coming out. Looking good.
Oh yeah, you got your flashlight? Let me get that so I can check behind, make sure nothing's hanging on.
Oh, we good. Yep, just checking to make sure there's nothing connected. I'm looking good. It's a pretty tight fit. This is when you gotta make sure you have everything unbolted, all the harnesses, all the wire connections undone. And this whole assembly will come out. It's pretty easy, man. I prefer to take the whole thing out than rather try to swap the transmission or engine with the other half in there. Like, some people like to, you know, change the transmission with the engine still mounted in, or vice versa, but it's just, I don't know. I feel like that's way too difficult. It's just tight spaces, man. It's just so much easier to just take the whole thing out together at once. It's literally just a few things you got to do to get it ready for that, and then you take the whole thing out and then swap everything over on the ground. But right here, we're just trying to, we found a little, I think it was a vacuum hose that was hooked up to the intake manifold. And it was just literally just a slip-on hose. We just slid it right off and it came off, no issue. Right here, we're backing the engine up.
Yeah.
I'm gonna place it next to the other motor so we can start swapping over the pieces that we need, like the alternator, the starter, and anything else, like the throttle body or whatnot. And right here, I'm showing the transmission or the flex plate bolts that hold the flex plate to the torque converter. This is an automatic transmission, so you have to take these bolts off in order to separate the transmission from the engine. If not, they're gonna just, it's going to probably slide the torque converter out, and then it'll leak transmission fluid everywhere. So just to keep the torque converter onto the transmission so you don't leak much fluid, we'll unbolt it from the flex plate. And then I'm right here. Now I'm showing the 17 millimeter bolts that are holding the rear transmission mount bracket. It bolts both the engine and the transmission together. And then that holds it to the subframe mount. Now, I did notice there was like the bolts that mounted to the engine were longer than the bolts that went into the transmission. So I just had to make sure I remember that when putting this all back together. Generally, I'll try to like leave the bolts in the hole of the mount when I take the whole mount off and just let it sit like that. So kind of remember where the bolts went. Now I'm breaking the transmission bolts. Again, they're 17 millimeters. I think there's like 5 or 6 transmission bolts. I don't know the exact number, but right here I'm just breaking them loose with my breaker bar, and then I zip them out with the impact gun. And that's it. So now I'm just going to show the starter bolts, and that's right under the intake manifold. Just lowering the assembly down now so we can separate the transmission. That'll all be in the next video. Thank you for watching.
back. No, we're here.